Icengineworks 3-inch 3000 FE 64-piece downpipe modelling kit. We've finally got these downpipe modelling kits in stock now. This is a kit that we've worked with Icengineworks to create to make something that's suitable for the UK market and gives you all the pieces you need to model and prototype 3-inch downpipes for whatever your application is, quickly and easily, with no waste and no confusion, so that when you begin to fabricate it, you can be confident that what you're going to create is going to fit and you can do it without any wastage. In the kit, you get 40 of the angle blocks, 20 1-inch long straights, 2 5-inch long straights, and 2 neoprene joiner blocks. So the idea is that you take your blocks, these are all 15 degree segments, and you can clip them together to create whatever angle you want within the 15, 30, 45, 60, 75, 90 and beyond range. But what's also nice is that these will rotate, so you can create compound bends, and then you can also use the lines to actually know how much rotation you've created in between a bend. They lock together nicely, they're a nice fit, they really snap in, and they're robust even when you've created quite a few pieces together and it's getting quite long. They don't really tend to fall apart. They are strong enough to hold into position. So these work perfectly with tight radius bends that we use a lot in the UK. We obviously use other radius of bends too, but 1.5D blocks aren't yet available. So this kit is primarily made just for using the 1D blocks. It's what we use the most when we're creating downpipes. They're usually in tight spaces, and that means that you're usually using the tighter radius bends. And it's also handy to only really have to have one type of bend radius in stock. So with this kit and with a handful of bends, you should really be able to make a downpipe for anything. These are a direct replica of the 1D bends. Only the 1D bends have a 34 millimeter leg on either end. So that's just something to remember as you're fabricating. And of course, the straights will just clip on the end as well. Again, they're a good fit and they snap into place to line the arrows up. The rubber blocks, they go on the end, in the female end, and these are a tight fit. You need them to be, because the idea is that these can take the weight of a tube. So if I were modeling a downpipe up underneath a car, and I was gonna have a nice long 1 meter length of tube running away from the downpipe that I've created, I can slot that tube over the end of this neoprene block, and then that can nicely go into the end of the tube. Again, these are a stiff fit. The idea is that it's so that they can take the weight of a lot of tube. So it usually takes a little bit to get them in, but there we go, it's in. And that'll slip directly into a 3-inch 1.5 millimeter wall tube. You get 40 of the angle blocks, which is enough for 6 90 degree bends and a few spare, which really should be enough for most downpipes, or a downpipe in any kind of space. We try to make a kit here which is really just the things you need. There are other kits, they do a basic kit and a pro kit, which we may begin to have at some point, but the problem with those kits is they have centerline blocks in the kits that there's just not really the availability of in the UK. So we've created this kit which just has the 1D blocks, just has the 1-inch straights and the 5-inch straights. And then this really should be everything you need to make downpipes for, you know, most of the common stuff, the European turbo stuff, you know, kind of bolt-on turbo stuff, Hondas, those kinds of things where you're doing turbo conversions. But they can also be used really anywhere else on the exhaust system where you want to be using 1D bends. So they come in great for over-axle sections, making little link pipes between silencers and other joint sections. Really whatever you want. And, you know, they can be used for bigger bore boost pipes. Some people make 3-inch boost pipes, 3-inch intakes. Really, when you start to kind of open your mind up to ideas and possibilities, there's loads of different things that can be, you know, that you can use them for. So yeah, it's just one thing that really will speed up the process. For me, it's just the ability to do things quickly and be able to change my mind without having to, you know, tape bends together, cut bends up, try and mark them. Once you've created whatever it is you want to create, you can easily mark it down. So if I wanted to make, you know, a little kinked section, so like two 45 degree bends together, something, I can just snap them together, line up the lines, and I know it's all along the same plane. If it happened to not be along the same plane, I could rotate it whatever I wanted, and then when I come to actually transfer this into steel, I could just measure the distance around between the two arrows, mark that out on my steel, and tack them together, and I know it's going to come out, you know, it's going to come out as accurate as you transfer the measurements. So the speed that you can do things with this kit, for me, makes it a no-brainer. I wouldn't need to be doing many a year for me to consider buying these. That was one of the reasons we wanted to bring them in. I wasn't convinced until I had tried them. I think that was primarily because of the availability of them, and just that I didn't think the kits really suited exactly what we needed, which is why we wanted to create a whole new kit. We've done that, and as far as I'm concerned, this is something that really should be in everybody's toolbox.